You've probably seen or visited the Hollywood sign, the Walk of Fame. But what about the Griffith Observatory? It's one of the most popular attractions in Los Angeles and boasts over 1 million visitors a year, making it the most visited public observatory in the world. But even if you haven't yet visited the Griffith Observatory, it's likely you've spotted it in movies throughout the decades. Nicholas Ray's Rebel Without a Cause stands as the film which truly captures the building and all its grandeur. It's in the Griffith Planetarium that the young, restless characters experience the sublime splendor of the cosmos, only to be knocked down to their brutal daily realities moments later outside on the observatory's deck. And when the three leads, played by James Dean, Natalie Wood, and Sal Mineo, seek shelter from their families, their peers, and the police, where do they head? Griffith Observatory. It's only fitting that a building whose purpose is to help orient men and women to their place in the universe would also stage the climax of a film about three lost youths on their own quest for solace. Perhaps that would have resonated with Griffith J. Griffith, who once said, "Man's sense of values ought to be revised. If all mankind could look through that telescope, it would change the world." Griffith was born in Wales, but immigrated to North America in his teens, making his fortune in Mexican silver mines in the late 19th century. Hoping to bring his vision of having science be more accessible to the public, Griffith proposed to the city of Los Angeles to build an observatory. At the time, it would only be the third observatory in all of the US. His lofty ambition wouldn't be realized in his lifetime. He died shortly thereafter in 1919. But with the support of the Federal Works Progress Administration, the building began construction in 1933. It was opened to the public on May 14th, 1935. Notably, Griffith Observatory houses a Foucault pendulum, a Zeiss telescope, a planetarium theater, a triple beam solar telescope, beautiful architectural details, and even this bust in honor of James Dean. Why does it show up so often in movies? For starters, its vistas of Los Angeles are magisterial. Who wouldn't try to stage some kind of epic brawl or fight so high above the city? Architecturally, the building harks back to a bygone era of the early 20th century, a quality that filmmakers get drawn to when recreating the past or attempting to reference older films meta-cinematically. In essence, the observatory reflects a romantic vision of nature and our place in the universe, trying to make sense of where we're going. Why wouldn't the movies jump on board?